first of all, just remember this. If it's loose when it's new, it will be sloppy when it's broken in. If it's snug when it's new, it'll probably break in just right. If you haven't had a lot of leather sheaths and leather sheaths have not been, high-end leather sheaths have not been a part of your regular life, there's a couple little things to keep in mind. Remember, when these get made, they get made and as they are getting sewn and glued and edged and all that, they kind of get tossed into a finished box. And then what happens is they've been worked, they have a tendency to shrink and tighten up a little bit without anything in them. Just like if you don't wear a belt for a year, it'll shorten just a little bit. So when you get a knife, a welt style knife like we've constructed here, these have been around for a long time and do really, really well. They're great because they've got some flexibility to them. They're quiet. They're easy on the finish of a knife. There are a lot of strengths to leather. And there are some weaknesses. They can capture moisture, yada, yada, yada. And you can poke a hole in them, unlike Kydex. So since you are going with something a little old school, there's absolutely a place for old school, just like there is in every other part of life where there's a place for old school. If you're gonna roll old school though, you gotta know a little bit about it. So a couple things, when your knife gets to you, it's gonna, now I've taken the strings off of this one here, but it'll basically be a knife in the sheath. And so what you wanna do to take it out is you wanna open up the knife, and on a leather sheath, I basically always grab it by the bottom. I never grab it on top. There is a tendency for humans, as you push your hands together, your elbows, when you push, your elbows don't have a tendency to go up. When you push, your elbows have a tendency to go down. So if you grab a sheath and you go to push and it's got some resistance because it's brand new, there will be a tendency for you to bend down a little bit, poke through the sheath, and go right into your hand. Okay? Now the sheath's going to come to you straight. And it's going to come with a knife in it, and it'll work really well. I tell everybody all the time, listen, it's not Kydex. Don't put your hand down at the bottom. Everything that you do is amplified if you hold it at the bottom. So this, if, you know, there is this, and it'll just stab right through here and go into your hand. So don't hold the knife like this. And it will, any little propensity you have for other than perfectly aligned will cause you problems. What I recommend you do, always hold the bottom, bottom of the sheath, never. Hold with your palm up towards the mouth of the sheath and gently work the knife into position. Now, when you get it, it'll have been sitting in here for some time, and the knife will now have kind of molded the sheath a little bit and stretched it to itself. When you get your knife, or you get a sheath that's been packaged outside for some reason, you may have a really tight start to this. So what you do is, hold it palm up. This is one that's never had a knife in it, so this one's gonna be really snug. You'll notice the mouth on this sheath, how it's raised up a little bit. And if you look down here, it's got some, it's a little bit convex. That's because it's had a knife sitting in it. So when we get it for the first time, you'll notice there's also a little jog to this. It's got a welt here for spacing to put some spacing on the back. Now you don't need to be have a PhD in sheath making, but the way this works, it's very thoughtful the way the sheath is, but when it's new and it hasn't broken in or been broken into a blade yet or mated, you can have this weird ledge right here that you stab through. So what you want to do, you want to hold it palm up, you want to kind of work it in and make sure that it's not stabbing a hole through the face of your sheath. Work it all the way down to seated, then from there you want to pull the snap tight, bring the female over and lock it, and you should have a sheath that has no wiggle, no play, and really good retention. Remember, quiet and good retention is paramount for a good tactical knife, a good combat knife, a good knife you carry in the military, or in the woods if you're a hunter. You don't want some knife rattling around in its sheath. You don't want some knife clanking around or dropping down at the last moment when you're 80 yards out with a bow on a 4-point buck you've been following. For whatever reason you're carrying a knife, quiet and retention is the most important thing. Putting it back in the sheath is never an emergency. So the thing about leather is that you gotta have a little more, you gotta be a little more mindful. So now after this sits in here for a day or two, it'll be molded really nicely. And you can see that step that was here, it's already gone from the knife being pushed in one time. I take the knife out. It's okay to hold it this way when you're removing the knife, okay? When I go to put it back in, I always hold it palm up by the mouth. That way the sheath will self-center itself. And this is stiff, man. There's resistance, and it's supposed to have it. Now, if you're not sure what to do with these cords, all you do is, this is to give you, if you happen to be an some guy that does some jump qualified and some jump work, and you need a double retention on any knife that gets approved for jumping out of helicopters or airplanes, all you have to do is loosen the cord up. Now, obviously, this is not for quick draw. This is, there's a lot of things you do with your kit when you're going to be jumping that are not set up for tactical quick draw. They're set up for getting on the ground without breaking your leg or having a knife sticking in your chest. So what we want to do with this is you'll loosen up the X, and then you'll tighten the knife around the X. Oh, look at me. I did it wrong right while I'm talking to you. There we go. And there we go. And then you tighten it up around the X. Again, this is some kind of preparatory thing you do to get ready. This is not something, this is not how you carry your knife in case you need to pull it out. But if you're looking for some extra retention, that's what this is for. You can put this X across your blade, and then you can tie this in here. However you want. And now you've met the requirement for dual retention, okay? So again, it's brand new, pull it tight. Now you've got this amazingly retained knife that will not come out on you if you're jumping or rappelling or whatever else. And then if you need to get to it, it's gonna require a little bit of wrangling. But just like everything else you do, if you've got some gear that you're setting up for jumping, once you're back on the ground, you've gotta re-rig your gear for cruising and doing what you gotta do. Getting your gear hump ready versus jump ready. So anyways, that's a little brief on how the sheath works. I recommend everybody take a couple minutes when you get your sheath, be mindful, read the little warning frame sheet in there, and watch this video, and don't poke a hole through your sheath, because they're $75 to replace, and you being a knucklehead is not a warranty item. Other than that, that knife sheath should last you for years and years and years and give you a ton of great service.